Hi. This is the fourth in a series of three lectures on dynamic programming solution to the weighted interval scheduling problem. In the previous three, I described the problem and gave a recursive solution and then gave a dynamic programming solution and stepped through it. The problem is described right here. I have a set of intervals which can be overlapping. And what I want to find is a subset of those intervals that maximizes the weight on non-overlapping intervals in that subset. Now, in the previous three lectures, I went through and I found that the value of an optimal set is, if I consider all of these intervals, 1 through 8, the value is 11. So you can go back and look at those previous solutions to see what the value is. Now, for this particular interval set, I have ordered the intervals by increasing finishing time. And to avoid unnecessary clutter, I've just labeled the weight or the value of each interval with the interval number itself. So you can see here I, that's my interval number. And for interval 7 is right here. And the value for 7 is given 7, and the value for 8 is 8. That's just for convenience. Whatever the value is what it is. Okay, so the second thing to point out here is this P, and what this, to repeat myself from previous lectures, what this P refers to is, for example, this interval 5 right here, in the ordered set of interval has four intervals that precede it in finishing time. So 5's finishing time is preceded by 4, 3, 2, and 1. Here's 5's finishing time, and here's the finishing time of the preceding 4, 3, 2, 1. That falls out, obviously, because that's how I have sorted the intervals. Now, the P is a non-overlapping preceding interval, so non-overlapping with 5. Okay, 4 does not overlap with 5, and neither does 3, etc. And then P is the rightmost one of all those non-overlapping preceding intervals. So for 5, the P is 4. Okay, if I look at, for example, at 6, the preceding intervals are 1 through 5 for terms of finishing time, but 6 overlaps with 5 and with 4. Of the set that remain, 1, 2, and 3, 3 is the rightmost. It has the latest finishing time. Okay, so we went through and found the value of the optimal set. Now, the problem is, or the issue that's really left is how to go about, I mean, what are the intervals? How to go about finding the intervals that are in the optimal set? And the way to do that is basically by tracing back through your solution right here with what you use to build the solution, which is your P's for each interval and your value or weights for each interval, and trace back through your set and essentially rebuild the solution of the intervals themselves by using the cost and the P and V. So here's the code right here, and we can see the code has a very similar feel to what we've seen in both the recursive definition, the recursive implementation, and the dynamic programming implementation. In both of those implementations, we saw something about the value of the interval under consideration plus the cost or the value of the optimal solution from the preceding set, the P of the interval under consideration, compared to the optimal solution where I don't include the interval under consideration. So I'm considering J. I'm considering J. This right here says, what's the optimal cost if the solution doesn't include J? Okay, so let's just trace through this right here and see what is our solution for our set of intervals 1 through 8. Okay, so I call this thing with FS of 8. Okay, so J is obviously not 0. So now I have to ask the question, is V of 8, which is 8, plus M of P of 8. Okay, P of 8 is 1. So M of 1 is 1. So that's plus 1. Is it greater than or equal to M of 8 minus 1 is 7? It's 11. The answer is question mark, and the answer is no. Okay, so that means I'm not going to output anything. I will output the result of FS of 8 minus 1. So I call FS of 7. What this means is that 8 is not included in the optimal set. Okay, now when I call FS of 7, I have to ask the question, V of 7 plus M of P of 7. P of 7, here's 7. P of 7 is 1. Here's my 1 again. M of 1 is 1, so add 1. Is that greater than or equal to M of 7 minus 1, that is M of 6. Here's 6, here's my M, that's 11, and the answer is no. So interval number 7 is not going to be included in the optimal set. All right, so 8's not included, 7's not included. So I need to call the find solution for 7 minus 1, which is 6. Perhaps 6 is included in the optimal set. So I have now the value of 6, which is 6, plus M of P of 6. P of 6, here's 6. P of 6 is 3. M of 3 is 4. So I have 6 plus 4. Is that greater than or equal to M of 5? M of 6 minus 1. 6 minus 1 is 5. So M of 5 is 11. The answer is no. So I will not be including 6. Okay, let us continue up here with the I have to call right here then, FS of 6 minus 1 is 5. Okay, so now I ask the question, V of 5, which is 5, plus M of P of 5. P of 5 is 4. M of 4 is 6. Is 5 plus 6 greater than or equal to M of 5 minus 1 is 4, M of 4 is 6? The answer is yes. Okay, so I need to output 5, put my output up here where I have room, and then I need to concatenate to that, calling the find solution for P of 5. So FS P of 5 is 4. Okay, so 5 is in the solution, and now I need to find what's the optimal solution if I just have this set right here. Find solution for the set 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so FS of 4, clearly not 0, so I need to say V of 4 is 4 plus M of P of 4. P of 4 is 2, right there. M of 2 is 2, so plus 2. Is that greater than or equal to M of 4 minus 1? That's M of 3, which is 4. The answer is yes. 6 is greater than 4. So I need to output 4 and concatenate the FS P of 4. So FS P of 4. P of 4 is 2. Okay, so 4 is included. Now I need to consider what are the elements in that set right there, 1 and 2. Okay, FS of 2, I need to answer the question, V of 2, which is 2, plus M of P of 2. Let's see, P of 2 is 0, M of 0 is 0. Is that greater than or equal to M of 2 minus 1? M of 1 is 1. Well, the answer is yes. So that means I will be including 2 in this set. I need to output 2 and concatenate FS of P of 2. FS P of 2. Here's 2. P of 2 is 0. Okay, if J equals 0, output empty. Yeah, nothing. We're done. So that's the end. So our set is 5, 4, and 2, And that has a weight of 5 plus 4, which is 9 plus 2, equals 11. That's my weight. So that's how you do the trace back to find the elements of the set which form our optimal solution to the weighted interval scheduling problem.